Our revision class of Madeenah Book 1, trying to take a few lessons or durus at a time. So this time, inshallah, we'll envisage to cover Dars al-Tasi', lesson 9, and Dars al-Ashir, lesson 10, and Dars al-Hadi Ashir, lesson 11. And Dars al-Tasi', they put it in two parts, Alif, and then a couple of pages down. Okay, how's it now? Back? Okay, alhamdulillah. So if it goes again, just let me know, inshallah, and we'll try that again.
Okay.
So, did you hear what I said over here, man hadha rajulu? Okay, so basically, Dars al-Tasi' is it's introducing how to describe things. How to describe things and how to describe people, using describing words. This is something that we do in any language. Someone tall, someone is short, someone's rich, someone's poor. A house is new, it's old, it's near, it's far. It's big, it's small. So here they start with this man, man hadha rajulu, who's this man? Huwa Abbasun, is Abbas. Abbasun Tajirun. Okay, now here, Abbas, this is Mubtada. This is in a sentence that begins with a noun, a nominal sentence. This is the introductory word that starts the sentence off that lets you know that we are talking about Abbas. When I said to you, Abbasun, now you're expecting to hear some information about Abbas. What about him? Give me some khabar, give me some news, give me some extra information. Information to complete the sentence, Tajirun. Abbas is a trader, he's a merchant, he's a tradesman, a businessman. Okay, Abbasun Tajirun. Abbas is a merchant. Okay, now the next sentence says, Abbasun Tajirun Ghaniyun. Now this word Ghaniyun turns up. Now Ghaniyun, which means rich, is describing the word Tajirun, meaning what kind of Tajir is he? He's a rich merchant. He's a rich Tajir. Okay. Now, this is called, this word here, it's a describing word. In Arabic language, they call it Na'at. Na'atun. Okay? It's referred to in many Arabic books as na'tun. Alright? And na'tun means a describer. Some may be familiar with the word adjective. And that's basically what na'tun is. It's a describer. Tajirun, this is what's being described. Anything that's being described as it relates to the na'at is called the man'ut. Basically, it's the described thing. The thing that is being man'ut. The thing that is being described is referred to as the man'ut. Man'ut. Tayyib. So, na'tun, let me give you a red arrow here, is this one here, is ghaniyun. And I'll give you another red arrow, or let's go for a blue one. Is tajirun. Okay, the man'ut. So, na'tun wa man'utun. The interesting thing is, we say that this is na'tun wa man'ut, but the na'at comes after the man'ut. The describing word in Arabic comes after the thing that's being described, as opposed to, let's say, for example, English. You don't say, you do say a rich man or a rich trader or a tall man. You don't say man tall or trader rich. So, whereas in the Arabic language, the adjective comes after the noun. So you say tajirun ghaniyun, merchant, rich. Meaning a rich merchant. Okay, guys. So, brothers, jazakumullah khairan. So far, we've noticed, we've seen that they've introduced straight away this concept of describing a noun using an adjective, using a na'at. And what's important to note here, and this is basically the three rules of the na'at. Three rules of na'at. The na'at has to follow the man'ut in everything that it does, in every way. So if the man'ut, which is this one here with a blue box around it, if the man'ut has alif wa lam, then the na'at must also have alif wa lam. And in the case that the man'ut does not have alif wa lam, like in the case that we have now, then the na'at will also be without alif wa lam. And that's the reason why you see the word na'at without alif wa lam. Why is it without alif wa lam? Because the man'ut is also without alif wa lam. Okay, that's number one. Rule number two, tajir. Is it a masculine word, mudhakkar, or is it a feminine word, mu'annath? Can anyone tell me, Brother Rasul or Brother Muzammin? Rasul Afwan hasn't got his mic. If we can give it to him, that'd be great, if he's willing to take it. So, is tajirun mudhakkar or mu'annath? Ahsant Rasul, it's mudhakkar, it's masculine. Barakallahu feek. So, therefore, well, how did you know that it wasn't mu'annath, is my question now. You told me it's mudhakkar, it's masculine. What's the sign that it isn't mu'annath, feminine? Or that it is mudhakkar, that it... Yeah, Ahsan, there's no ta. There's no ta marbuta, which is what indicates in many cases that this is feminine. Okay, so that would have been tajiratun, female merchant or tradeswoman. But tajirun is a man. Okay, so if the man'ut is mudhakkar, masculine, then the na'at is also going to be mudhakkar, in that it does not have a ta marbuta. You can now conclude that if the word tajir was mu'annath and it said tajiratun, then this na'at, this word ghani, would have been. Go ahead.
Marbuta at the end.
Yeah, Can you recite it? Can you read the word? How would have been?
Tamarbutu at the end.
Yes, so the word would therefore have been ghaniyatun. Jazakallahu khair. So tajiratun ghaniyatun. If you want to describe tajiratun as mu'annath, then you will have to use a mu'annath na'at, which is tamarbutu at the end, as you said. So the thing is, looking at the gender of the word, is it mu'annath or is it a mudhakkar, is it mu'annath? And thirdly, you want to see what is the grammatical state of that word. Does it have dhamma on the end? Does it have kasra on the end? Does it have fatha on the end? So if it has dhamma, then the na'at also takes dhamma. If it has kasra, the na'at also takes kasra. And if it takes fatha, then the na'at also takes fatha. Or let's be more precise, if it is in the state of being majroor, which means usually taking kasra, then the na'at will also take a kasra. If the man'ut is in the state of marfu', where it usually takes a dhamma, then also that will be the case with the na'at, and the same for mansub, where it takes a fatha. In most cases, fatha, then in that case, the na'at will have a fatha. So, quite simply, the man'ut dictates how the na'at behaves. If the na'at wants to describe this man'ut, then it has to first check mudhakkar or mu'annath, masculine or feminine. If it's mudhakkar, then you come with a mudhakkar na'at. Then you have to also check alifulam or no alifulam. If there's no alifulam, or let's be more precise, ma'rifah, meaning definite. And the reason we're saying that now is because a word can be ma'rifah, definite, even without alifulam. And we learned that a couple of lessons ago. Can anyone tell us how a word can be ma'rifah without alifulam? Ya ahsant, barakallahu feek, jazakallahu khair. Now, while if a word is mudaf, and then that mudaf is ma'rifah, and mudafun ilayhi is what gave it cause to be ma'rifah, then the word that comes after the na'at will come after the mudafun ilayhi, and it will be describing following the first word, the mudaf, describing the mudaf. And as the mudaf in that case will be ma'rifah, then the na'at is also going to have alifulam on it, in order to fulfill the condition of being ma'rifah, the state of being ma'rifah rather. And lastly, depending on the man'ud, whether it's in a state of marfu', which is usually with a dhamma, or majroor, which is usually seen with a kasra, mansub, usually seen with a fatha, depending on that, the na'at will also follow in that same way, accordingly. Now they gave some other examples here. They said, Hamidun mudarrisun. Hamidun mudarrisun jadidun. Hamidun mudarrisun jadidun. So which one is describing and which one is being described? Which one is the na'at and which one is the man'ut? Rasul?
Mudarrisun man'ut and jadidun na'at.
Barakallahu feek. Ahsant. The mudarris is the man'ut. Now, Bahi, is that what you said, yeah?
Yeah.
No. So the jadidun is the na'at and mudarrisun is the man'ut. Ma hadha? Hadha tufahun. At-tufahu fakihatun. What is the tufah? A tufa is a fakihatun, is a fruit. Okay. Describe this fruit. Ladhidhatun. Fakihatun, ladhidhatun. Okay. Which of these is na'at and which of these is man'ut?
Fakihatun man'ut and ladhidhatun na'at.
Barakallahu feek. What do we see here? Still, fakihatun is nakira, is without alif ulam. Therefore, ladhidhatun is without alif ulam. Fakihatun has tamarbuta, is mu'annath. And the na'at also has tamarbuta, is mu'annath, for that reason. This is with dhamma, and this is also with dhamma. So they're related in that way. Change the color. Let's go for green, maybe. We've got tamarbuta here. Oh, I chose green, but it didn't come up. I'm showing you how to work these colors and keep them permanent. Okay. And that goes and joins with this tamarbuta. So you got tamarbuta, tamarbuta, you got dhamma and dhamma, and no alif ulam, also no alif ulam.
Yeah, Ustaz, I have a question.
And then he continues another example. Ustaz, I have a question. Fadl Akhi.
Why not hakihun?
Why not
hakihun? Because we not know mubtada and khobar mess with one is other.
I see. Well, mubtada and khobar, does it match with each other?
In gender.
In gender. That's a good question. No, like for example here, he Muzammil, Abbasun Tajirun. You're not going to say Abbasun Tajiratun. It has to match the gender. So Hamidun Mudarrisun, not Mudarrisatun, because they have to match the gender. That's a fair question. But what's happening here? It seems that At-Tufahu is speaking about. At-tufah is a type of fakiha, and one apple, one tufah, is called tufahatun. So what is this? This is known as ism jins. I'm not sure the name in English. Ism at-tufah, ism jins, basically is the group name for that particular thing, the group name. So what family does it belong to is being identified, as being from the fruit family. So it's basically it's a fruit. So, well, I don't think I'm giving you a clear answer. I don't think I have the answer. Yeah. So, at-tufahu fakihatun. So if the gender is clearly known, and the khabar relates to that gender, then you will mention that. Use it in the same gender. But if you're identifying the noun to be of a particular type, then that type will be mentioned according to its own gender. That's the only explanation I can give. Is that okay, Rasim?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's not going to break the rule, as you pointed out correctly. Now, if the mubtada is mudhakkar, then the khabar is also going to be mudhakkar. If the mubtada is mu'annath, then for sure, generally speaking, because we've seen the rule over here being applied maybe slightly differently. If it's mu'annath, then the khabar is also going to be mu'annath. Jayid? So then the other example they gave, al-usfuru ta'irun. It's a bird. Al-usfuru ta'irun. What type of ta'ir is it? Well, how would you describe it? Saghirun. It's a small bird. So which of these words is the na'at and which is the man'ut?
Ta'irun is man'ut. And saghirun is na'at.
Ahsanta. Barakallahu fik. And then they said, العربية لغة سهلة. Arabic is an easy language. سهلة being the منعوت of being the نعت of one, the describer, and لغة being the منعوت. That's what's being described. How would you describe this language? It's easy. It's an easy language. Okay? Let's go to the next page. Then they said, العربية لغة جميلة. So again, لغة is being described as a beautiful language. Then they introduced a new student called عمار. He's a student. عمار طالب. What type of a student is he? He is مجتهد. He's مجتهد. And then another student, and مجتهد means hardworking. And then there's another student called محمود. He's also a طالب, so he's also a student. That's the خبر. But he is not a مجتهد. He is كسلان. Now, كسلان over here, this is the نعت. And طالبٌ, this is the منعوت. Whoop. What's happened there? My screen went onto the side. Oh, is it flipped from your side?
I think the speed is not weird. All of a sudden, you know, the speed.
I can see the page there just now, but it's right on its side. If I go to 45, it's on its side. If I rotate it, now it's the right way around. Can you see it?
Okay.
Can you see it?
Yeah.
You can't see this page. Can you see my writing?
Yes. Right.
Oh, I see. You can't see the text. Yeah, if you want to go ahead. You want to do something? I'll make it easy. Hope to see you back in a second, inshallah. Page 45. Page 45. You got it? Did you go page back? No. There it is. Okay. So we were saying that this student here, Mahmoudun, is Talibun Kaslanu. This word Kaslanu, it is the Na'at, and this word here, Talibun, this is the man'oot. A group. Testing, testing.
Yes.
Okay, alhamdulillah. My screen is blank. Okay, whiteboard 3 is there. So what we were saying was that these were, can you hear me?
Yeah.
What we were saying were that these words here, they are this na'at that finishes with alif and noon. It only has one dhamma. The reason for this one dhamma is because of alif and noon. That's the answer. So the words that finish with alif and noon, they only have one dhamma. So talibun kaslanu. And then later on in the exercises, you find some examples of other words that also finish with only one dhamma. Let's have a look at some of those exercises now. Are there any examples in the Quran of na'at and man'ut? Have a look, some of those ayat, if we can find them. The documents are showing a blank page. أخي أستاذ مزمل I see not I can't see them. Let me try to add it from my side. Document from my computer. Let me see if I can upload it from my side and see what happens.
Yeah,
Okay, can you see that?
Yeah.
Great. Let's go therefore to 7. Yeah, the surah, yeah? Yeah. So, some examples in the Quran for Unat and Man'ut, Surah Al Baqarah, ayah 168. إنه عدو مبين إنه لكم عدو مبين. If you go to the ayah, you'll see that Allah Ta'ala says يا أيها الناس كلوا مما في الأرض حلالا طيبا ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين. Do not follow the footsteps of Shaitan. Indeed, he is an enemy to you. What kind of an enemy? Mubinun. Clear enemy or open enemy. So Mubinun over here, this is the Na'at. And it's describing the type of enemy that he is. Another example you find in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 197, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about Hajj. So Allah Ta'ala says, Al-Hajju Ashhurun. Hajj is a number of months. Which months? What kind of months? Ma'lumatun. Well-known months. So Ma'lumatun, this is the Na'at, and Ashhurun, which is plural, is being described. Ashhurun ma'lumatun. Na'atun ma'ud. Going back to the book, the second part of Adars al-Tasi' part B, section Ba, has been introduced with a new dialogue. أين المدرس هو في الفصل وأين المدرس الجديد. Over here they're showing examples of النعت ومنعوت, but this time is with Alif and Lam. The example now is معرفة. أين المدرس, where is the teacher? Which teacher? الجديد, the new teacher. And therefore, I wanted to show an example in the Quran, Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 256, which is the ayah immediately after ayah al-Kursi, which everyone should know is ayah 255. فَقَدْ اسْتَمْسَكَ بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى بِالْعُرْوَةِ الْوُثْقَى. Al-urwa, bil-urwati, because of the ba, which is a harful jar, this word has a kasra. It has alifulam. And it is with ta marbuta, as mu'annath. So the na'at follows those three rules, those three states rather. Alifulam, that's number one. It's also majroor, with a, although you can't see the kasra. The reason you can't see the kasra because it has alif maksoor on it. And this word, wuthqa, is the mu'annath form of this word. It's the feminine form of this word. Okay, let's go back to the lesson, درس التاسع. با, أين المدرس الجديد, where is the new teacher? أين الطالب الجديد, where is the new student? ذهب إلى المكتبة. Okay, he went to the library, and then he said, من ذلك الرجل? Who is that man? Which man? What type of, how would you describe him? الطويل. That tall man. من ذلك الرجل الطويل? Well, that طويل is describing the رجل. But there's actually more than one طويل person that you're, that's around you. So, من ذلك الرجل الطويل? Well, you want to describe him further, identify him further. So he says, الذي, الذي خرج الآن من المدرسة. And the word الذي, if you want to translate it to English, you'll say who or that, maybe even which. And it's known as a relative pronoun. And in Arabic, it's known as ism mawsool. Mawsool, basically, it creates a connect, so it's a connector. It's connecting two ideas together. It's connecting what this Rajul Tawil did to who did the action. It's connecting his action to the person. So, من ذلك الرجل الطويل? Who is that tall man? الذي خرج الآن من المدرسة? That left the school. That just left the school right now. Just left the school right now. So, الذي means who. And there are ayat in the Quran that have similar usage. Let's see if these ayat are those. This particular ayah here, this is labeled wrong. Alladhi should be coming a bit later. But here I wanted to show the word ghadban being used in the Quran. The word ghadban. فَرَجَعَ مُوسَى إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ غَضْبَانَ أَسِفًا. Over here, it takes a fatha because it's relating to the verb, the action that was done, and the state that he was in when he returned to his people. He was grieved and distressed by what they had done when they had taken their the calf as a an object of worship. Surah Taha, Surah 20, Ayah 87, Ghadban is mentioned there. But the word, going back to the issue of ism mawsool, alladhi, that should have been labeled from this point. I'll write the label there right now. Alladhi. Okay. And then we have qala inna rasulakum alladhi ursila ilaykum la majnun. In Surah Al-Shu'ara, Surah 26, Ayah 28. They said, indeed, rasulakum, your messenger, الذي أرسل إليكم, that has been sent to you, la majnun, is certainly mad. This was the things that they were saying, lying against the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the reason why Allah Ta'ala commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to have sabr, to have patience. فَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا يَقُولُونَ. Say, be patient about what they say about you. So, الذي, who, meaning the messenger. رسولكم الذي أرسل إليكم المجنون. Also, Surah Ash-Shura, Surah 42, Ayah 18. Surah 42, Ayah 18, Allah Ta'ala says, الله الذي أنزل الكتاب بالحق والميزان وما يدريك لعل الساعة قريب. Allah is the one who Anzal al-Kitab, who revealed the book with truth and justice. Bil-haqi wal-mizan, the scale. So, Allahu alladhi. Allah is the one who revealed the book, who sent down the book. These are examples of alladhi being used in the Quran. Also, at the beginning of Surah Al-Kahf, Surah 18, Ayah 2. Alhamdulillah. Praise belongs to Allah. Alladhi anzala ala abdihi al-kitab. Who sent down upon his servant the book. Walam yaj'al lahu iwaja. And he did not place any crookedness therein. Alhamdulillah alladhi. Praise belongs to Allah. Who? So alladhi is connecting the next part of the sentence to the previous part. Anzala ala abdihi al-kitab. Who? Allah. Also, anzala al-kitab bil-haqqi wal-mizan. Who? Allah. That's how it should look. Arrow going back and arrow going back. Also, alladhi ursila ilaykum, that has been sent to you. Alladhi ursila ilaykum, and then also alladhi refers to the Rasul. Rasulakum alladhi, who was sent to you. No, Rasul. Jayyid? So, that is the introduction of alladhi ism mawsool. Further to that, they said kharaja al-ana min al-madrasati. Kharaja. So that was something else which was mentioned in the Dars al-Tasi', the verbs kharaja, and those words that have, you know, the book mentions other examples of these verbs. You can see them in the exercises. They said, just go forward by a couple of pages, you'll see some examples after they mention different things. They said, where is it? Oh. So I was just trying to find the example of some words, the verbs like kharaja, went out, he went out, dhahaba, he went, or he went towards. Kharaja means he exited, he left. And jalasa, he sat. Raja'a, he returned. So you have to see the past, you have to learn the meaning of verbs. And the past tense verb is often only three letters, and it often only has fathas on it all the way through. It always finishes with the fatha anyway, and starts with fatha as well. And the middle letter sometimes has a dhamma, sometimes has a kasra, but often it has a fatha. So this ayah, that we, the one we looked at with the word qadban in it, faraja'a Musa. Musa returned ila qawmihi. Raja'a. Rajim'in. See another example. You might find another example in the Quran. Let's go to it. I think I placed it later on in the list. There it is. فَخَرَجَ مِنْهَا خَائِفًا يَتَرَكَّبْ فَخَرَجَ خَرَجَ مِنْ مِنْهَا. So the word خَرَجَ, which means exited, often comes with min, exiting from something. Often it comes with min, not always, but often it comes with min. Kharaja minha. Jayyid. Let's look at some of the exercises that they placed in this book, in the section. These are the examples as it related to Mawsool. الذي الطالب الذي خرج من الفصل الآن الكتاب الذي على المكتب. طيب. Then they just reiterated the lesson. بيت جديد نعت and منعوت. Okay. We want to move on to الدرس العاشر. It's actually Isha here right now. We may have to just pause. Unfortunately, we didn't cover the amount that we wanted to cover. And therefore, I think we're going to have to pause it there, Akhi Muzammil, Afwan. Yeah, Qadr wa Masha Fa'al. We should have taken more than, I think Dars al-Tasi' is quite long and there's a number of points of benefit to learn from it. And the issue of Na'at al-Man'ut is, yes, which is quite tricky, requires some focus and time, inshallah, to practice as well, to recognize. So our time seems to have gone there, apart from the technical issues that we had coming and going. So those are the points that we've got to look at in the Adars al-Tasi', which is Na'at al-Man'ut with Nakira, and then Na'at al-Man'ut with Ma'rifa, and the rules of Na'at al-Man'ut, the three rules, looking at the whether it's Alif ul-Lam, whether it's Mu'annath al-Mudhakkar, and the grammatical state of that word, if it's Dhamma or Kasra or Fatha. Those exceptions to those adjectives, those Nu'ut that only finish with one Dhamma, like Kaslanu, Jaw'anu, hungry, Attashanu, thirsty, and Ghadbanu, with one Dhamma, angry. And that was mentioned in the ayah as well about Musa alayhi salam's people angering him due to them having fallen into Shirk Akbar. And Ism Mawsool, very important. Ism Mawsool, Alladhi, using Alladhi to connect two parts of a sentence together. Okay, we'll stop there. Bi-ithnillahi ta'ala, we'll take a dars al-ashir, al-hadi ashir, and maybe also al-thani ashir if we have time. Next lesson. Well, I'm sure we wanted to go much faster than this, and we will have to pick up the pace. Inshallah, hopefully we will be able to do that and complete the revision sessions so we can have a small test and thereafter commence with book two, bi-ithnillahi ta'ala. طيب إخوة أوكي مزمل طيب الله يبارك فيك حياكم الله take care of سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت سبحانك اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته
وعليكم السلام ورحمه الله وبركاته